Hi, and welcome to this introduction movie of FlightCheck Designer. Together with its big brother, FlightCheck Professional, the only standalone desktop application that will check 50 plus file formats, including Adobe InDesign, QuarkXPress, PDF, Adobe Photoshop and Illustrator, Word, and CorelDRAW, just to name a few. FlightCheck Designer is created for those creatives and graphic designers who need an accurate but simple to understand quality control check and advanced packaging of all fonts and images with the job before sending off to the printer. Once you have installed FlightCheck Designer, the first thing you will notice is the toolbar containing the buttons you need to work with the application. Let me explain what they do. Let's start with the most important one, the ground control button. Note that we designed a separate ground control window specially created for checking either open file structures like Quark and InDesign or for checking PDF files. You can switch between them by choosing File, Preflight Mode, the language of your choice, and PDF or non-PDF. When checking files, FlightCheck Designer will detect whether your document is a PDF or an open file type and will switch automatically to the right ground control set. Let's go back to the ground control window of the open files. Using the category tabs, which are colors, fonts, and images, you have access to the wide variety of settings, all designed to check files before sending them off to the printer or into the workflow. These are the options for activating such a rule. Clicking it once, it will show a small dot. The rule is now set to give you a warning. You may still proceed with the file, but you should keep an eye on this during the workflow. Examples where this might be used is, for instance, PMS color setting. Clicking it again shows a big dot. The rule is now set to give you an error. When an error is found, the file should be corrected before it's taken off into production or sent off, as it will certainly give you problems later on. Examples where you want to set the rule to an error are missing images, low resolution, RGB colors, etc. Whenever you are not sure what a rule checks for, just hover over the rule name and FlightCheck Designer will explain it to you. On the top of this window, you see the Set pull-down menu. Let's go in there to explain what great options can be found in there. All the way up, we start with the New Set option. Selecting this option will create a copy of the settings currently active. Lets you give it another name and will save it. This way, it is very easy to duplicate settings, make mirror adjustments between them, and provides you multiple sets to choose from through the same menu. The Get More option will lead you to our website where you will find standardized ground control sets like PDFX and hand work group settings, ready to use and free of charge. Then there are the Rename and Delete options that speak for themselves. The Turn All Off option is great when you want to create a new set from scratch. It creates a new set with all rules switched off. You are now able to activate the rules you are absolutely sure of, and thus create a rule set that totally fits your specific needs. You could also choose to set all rules to either warning or error, but these options are not used as often as the turn all off option. Reset all to initial settings will revert to the settings as they were when the set was created. The options import ground control sets and export ground control sets are great if you either have an external partner that uses either FlightCheck Designer or FlightCheck Professional, or if you want to spread your settings internally. You can import a setting from, let's say, your printer to make sure you will check your files with their settings, making sure the file fits their needs once you send it off to them. Or you can export your settings to be used with your customers or colleagues, making sure a standardized workflow is created. When exporting your ground control set, protecting it with a password using the password option prevents people from making changes to your set, either on purpose or by accident. What I will show you now is that even when you don't have the time to go over all the rules in the ground control, you can still use FlightCheck Designer to see if your document is ready for output. We will now check a document to see if we can detect errors in there that are in the top 10 of prepress problems. To start checking a file using Marksverse FlightCheck Designer, simply use the Open button or go to File and Open. This will open a window that allows you to open the file you want to examine. Note that you will only have to point to the actual document. FlightCheck will find the images and the fonts used in the document for you. Just select the file and click on the Open button at the bottom of the window. FlightCheck Designer will now check your documents, the used images and the used fonts for errors. A very thorough check that would take a lot of time if you had to do this with the eyeball method. When it's ready checking your file, FlightCheck Designer shows two windows. The result window and the general overview window. Let's first have a look at the result window. The result window displays all the errors and warnings found checking the document with the ground control set you chose. The errors are displayed in red, the warnings in blue. This gives me already a ton of information about the document. I can see that certain screen fonts are not installed, a printer font is not available, some images are in the RGB color mode, some pictures are off page, and the effective resolution of these pictures is out of range, just to name some. Note that the information in the result window is far more effective when the proper ground controls are set in the ground control menu. Now, let's have a look at the general overview window. Even though it looks quite complicated, it is really easy to get the information you are looking for. Where the result window only displays the errors and warnings, the general overview window shows you all information. Again, the errors are displayed in red and the warnings in blue. All items without errors are now also visible, displayed in black. Simply by using the pull-down menu, it is easy to detect, for instance, the spot colors that are used in the document, number 3 in the top 10, and if they were used in the text or in an image. This makes correcting this error a piece of cake. Just as easy is it to filter out missing fonts, number 1 on the list, and image problems by using the pull-down menu. Note that far more information is available in this window than there was in the result window. When we have a look at the image section, we get instant information on the page the image is placed in the document. The status of the image, number 6 and 9 on the list, the file size, the type of image, the color mode, number 4 on the list, the DPI value of the original image, the scaling and the output resolution of the image, number 10 on our list. Note that FlightCheck Designer will calculate the output resolution and will act on that value. A 72 DPI image scaled to 24% will still give you a 300 DPI output resolution, which is fine in most cases. With this simple overview, we covered all items from our top 10 list and more that cannot be solved once we created a PDF or did send our file off to the next station in our workflow. Before I sign off, let's go over the remaining buttons available in FlightCheck Designer button bar. We covered the Open button. With the Add button, we are able to add documents to this ticket. Good to have when you, for instance, create a book with a different file for every chapter. The Preference button gives you access to the program settings of FlightCheck, all described in the manual of FlightCheck. Clicking the Launch Doc button simply launches the document, a cool feature that adds to the speed correcting the document. You can search for an image using the Find Image button and recheck the document with the Recheck button when you made corrections in the document. Of course, you can print the reports to go with the document, giving you a printed guidance of what needs to be done to make it a perfect document. Last but not least, you can collect. Only the reports saved as a text document or the whole document, including all used images and fonts. This last option is absolutely great, for it makes sure all used elements of the file will be collected or packaged and placed in the folder, either compressed or uncompressed, ready to send off. I hope this video gave you a good insight into FlightCheck Designer. Please have a look at our website at www.marksware.com for more information. Also, have a look at FlightCheck Designer's big brother, FlightCheck Professional, that enables you to check even more. Also, feel free to contact us for placing your order or if you have any additional questions. Thank you for watching. This is Olga, signing off.